I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website, www.tarobyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity, be it in your love lives or your career, for a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarobyanisha@gmail.com. Aries, welcome to your May 2021 horoscope. It's quite an interesting month. We have a Mercury retrograde towards end of the month. We have Jupiter that it's changing its sign mid-month. And then we have a solar and a lunar eclipse as well this month. We begin the month with Mercury that is moving to Gemini in your house of communication. And this is a time where you will find it very hard to control your thoughts, Aries. There's going to be a lot of conversation happening in your head, a lot of ideas, a lot of thoughts. But the only issue will be that you will not be able to stick to one specific thought. Mercury is going to be making your mind very busy. It can be that for some of you, you are and you have been looking at a new opportunities, and this has been going on for the last 4.5 months to move into a newer career segment. Maybe some of you have been looking at starting your own work. In some cases, it may also have to do a collaboration with a sibling, or maybe a sibling is a key or the resource, someone who can really help you out as far as the passion project or the dream project, or maybe it is something that you're winding up at the work front and you know, there is no choice, but this seems to be the logical way ahead. So Mercury is going to be making you dig deeper. It's going to be making you to explore a lot of projects. There are going to be a lot of short trips that are going to be involved. And you'll find that you're having a lot of these brief conversations, discussing ideas with people. And you have a lot to say this month, Aries, and vice versa. It's, however, for some of you, it's a good time to be exploring newer things as well. So if you have not tried to, say, venture into farming, for example, this is a time that, you know, you can completely sort of pick up something absolutely new and start learning over there. On the 9th, we have Venus that moves into your house of communication as well, and it's going to be encouraging you to be soften your conversations, and you'll find that people are really attracted to what is it that you are seeing. Now we have, of course, Gemini is a sign of duality, so there can be instances wherein that, you know, you have to be quite careful, have your guard up, because with a Geminian energy, you're never sure. You know, they may say something, they may seem, you know, some other way, and they may act in a totally different way. So try not to buy a story or an idea the first time that you hear it, even though you may be finding the idea very interesting. On the 11th, we have a new moon that is set in Taurus, and it is resonating with Uranus over here. And this is there in your house of earned income and your value system. And this has been, of course, been you know, being shaken up since the last 4 years, and it carries on being so till about 2025. And new moon indicates a time of new beginnings. You know, maybe an ability to create a new revenue stream for yourself. You'll also be looking at your own sense of self-worth, and Aries, try and keep your ego on a side this month. And this really doesn't have to do with confrontations, but I think it more has to do with, you know, if you need help, if you need to be collaborating, or even if it, you know, if it's a project that is there with a cousin or someone in the family, try not to sort of, you know, let your entire sense of ego crop up and say, oh, how can I do this, or I've been doing so well and I don't think so I can. This is really not the time, or even it is not something that is going to be perceived as whatever the story that you may be telling in your mind. It's a time and space, Aries, where you need to be coming together with like-minded people, and you need to be forming a collaboration. On the 14th, we have the big movement this month, that is Jupiter, that is changing signs. It is moving to Pisces, and it moves into your house of behind the scenes. This is the house of spirituality. And Jupiter, no matter which house it comes and it touches, it expands, it broadens our outlook over there. So for you, you will find that there is a lot of growth and expansion as far as your subconscious is concerned, as far as your spiritual realms are concerned. And it's a time of renewal. It's a time for the hidden worlds of the subconscious to sort of emerge. So if there have been any fears, any patterns, you know, that have not been allowing you to take a risk and to move ahead, or you know, you may realize during this time that you are your biggest enemy. It's not that people don't want to help, and sure, I mean, you know, everybody is not helpful, but try not to let your fear of rejection, if it exists, get in the way of you trying to realize a dream or even to create a source of income for yourself. And it's a great time during mid-month to be learning more about spirituality, to be connecting with your higher self. And you will find that you have more compassion, you have more empathy for those who are suffering, and you would want to help. And this could be another way of healing yourself, Aries. It's a great opportunity for you to be helping those who are not in a position to be helping themselves. And in fact, during this time, some of you may find a spiritual teacher. And also, even if you know there is not one big aha moment and you don't find that teacher, you realize that as you are going out and helping those who are not in a position to do so, you're healing your own karmas. So it's really, I think, a gift that you are giving yourself, you know, rather than being in a space and saying, oh, I'm giving charity or I'm doing charity. It's on the reverse, that you are healing certain parts of your life, you know, which you may not be really conscious of now, and hence undoing the karma over there. On the 21st, we have Sun that is there again in your house of communication and sibling. And on the 26th, we have a lunar eclipse that is there in your house of spirituality. It's a house of expansion and growth of the mind, and it also involves long distance travel, though I do not know in the pandemic how that is going to be possible. But I think growing from a spiritual perspective and realizing how your belief system affects who you are as a person could come about with this placement. And if you find that it is really, you know, affecting you positively, you may choose to follow it. You may choose to dig more deeper, study something about spirituality, and you may sort of, some of you may just, you know, change the way that you operate, change the way that you think, change the way that you look at life. And you'll find that, of course, you know, when we grow spiritually, there is an overall personality change as well. And if there have been some legal issues or some legal dealings or complications that have been going on, they could come to an end as well during this time. And it's, I think mid-month is a time where you will feel that you really need to, or there has been a space of stagnation for you, and you really want to grow and you really want to push yourself and sort of what is it that you are doing, you know, about it, and hence it will make you take an action. End of the month, 30th, we have Mercury that goes retrograde, and it's going retrograde again in your house of communication. So the first 3 weeks, we have your house of communication, conversations, negotiations, networking, sibling interactions, short distance travel, something new to learn. All of that is really active. And end of the month, we move into a, if I were to sum it in three keywords, it's rewind, it's rethink, and it is revise. So there's going to be a lot of focus that is going to be there, in which, you know, you're going to be sort of going back and you're going to be checking on the contracts, you're going to be checking on the negotiations, ensure that you have sent me, if you have sent mails to some, you know, an important email or text messages, that call up those people and see whether they have received or not. Ensure that you have your computer backups, your data is stored. For those of you who are traveling, and importantly, you should not be traveling. It is a pandemic. You should be staying at home. But for whatever reason, if you have to travel, and if you are traveling, or even if you're going, you know, on your own solo somewhere, or for whatever reason that you need to travel, ensure that your travel dates, everything is sort of checked and rechecked, because Mercury has a tendency to, you know, put things in a glitch, and a lot of confusion happens. Diffuse arguments as well during the retrograde. It is not a great time to be wanting to confront people and let them know how you feel and try and sort of sort it all out. Not a good time. It's just a general reshuffle until everybody feels comfortable where they are and which position they are, and including yourself. So try to work on removing the obstacles which you know, hamper the flow, and diplomatically also, you know, reschedule your work, your whatever it is that needs to get done, and try and fit whoever best can fit to their ability. And towards the end of the retrograde, and during the retrograde as well, you may have to call into question some part of your financial decisions that you may have taken, and you may have to sort of you know, relook at them so that you're able to reach your desired goal. It's been a pleasure speaking with you, Aries. I'll see you again soon.